first spot. We're at a place right next to the ramp, and I have all my like bank fishing stuff on recently just because, like I said, I haven't been on the boat. So we're gonna cut this off. This is the chatter donk that I've had a lot of good luck on recently. I've been throwing this thing, I think, for 4 or 5 weeks without breaking it off. I actually bent off the hook and everything multiple times. I have no idea how I have not lost this chatterbait, but it's my little lucky white and chartreuse chatter donk. We're gonna start off with a underspin today. This is one of my favorite baits to throw of all time. I do apologize for the yard work in the background, but I haven't thrown one of these in a while, and this was one of my confidence baits back in, I'd say 2014 through 2016. This was like my favorite bait of all time, was an underspin or a fish head. It just catches the fish, especially the spotted bass. I mean, you can just crush them on it. If you guys watched one of my winter linear videos from last year, I caught that like 4.5 pound spot in like 65 foot of water, I think it was, on an underspin. So hopefully we'll get on some deep bass today. Pulled into this creek, we scanned out here at the mouth of it, right down the ditch in the middle, and there was a ton of bait. So I'm actually gonna go right back over that, just make sure we're not fishing dead water, and chuck this underspin. And we'll talk about how I'm throwing it here in a moment. We're just gonna put a little tiny paddle tail on the end. This is like a white ice color, it's not a straight pearl. So we're just taking a basic little paddle tail. I believe this is like 3.75 inch. Yeah, it's about a 4 inch paddle tail. This one's like a white ice. It's got pearl and that clear translucent with sparkles. My bait's not perfect, I ain't fishing it. There we go, right there. Boom. Got some beautiful little underspin. The paddle tail, see how you can tell there's like a pearl, just a basic white on top. Then you got this translucent color on the bottom, half the bait with sparkles in it. And it's got a regular pearl head underspin. So that's perfect. We're gonna start fishing. We're gonna scan right here and see if we can find some more bait, see if we can find some fish stacked up on the bottom, and go from there. Hopefully we'll have a awesome day.
Alrighty, let's go ahead.
I saw all that bait out there, and I was just putting two and two together. Figured we would try it.
Let's see.
It was weird, like you wouldn't ever scan them in that bait, but you drop it in there and you can see them come out of it. There's fish to the left. See that? Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
They're following you.
Yeah, I'm about to get one. Right here. Watch this.
They'll bite it.
It has to have like 5 fish falling down right away. Watch this. Whoa. What are you doing,
man? Look at him.
Look at them all. There's one on me right now. Look, he followed me up. You see that? Watch, I'm going to stop it. You see him following me down? These are catchable. If you guys are wondering what I'm doing right now, I'll show you on my graph. We have all this bait. It's all slick of bait. That's my line going down right there with the spoon. These are all bass. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Those are all bass that followed me down. They just weren't interested. We gotta fire them up. All right, spot number 2. Let's see how it treats us. Oh my gosh.
Amazing.
That was
sick. Start off with this fish head, and then we'll, as we start, we're only in 30 foot, man.
Oh, I ain't gonna be able to hook that.
That thing friggin' launched me right there. You hit it twice. Just went thump.
this man about to hit. Bro, this man ain't about to hit. You good? Something float through. I was talking to the camera and I was like, this guy's about to hit. Like, he was literally about to hit and I didn't know if I should say something. Like, he looked back at his boat and he looked at the bridge. I'm like, dude, you are not fitting that. And so we like started to put it in reverse. I'm like, all right, he's gonna back up. And he just went right through, dude. His poles were like bent over, his whole roof of his boat was scraping across. Yeah, I got it on camera. I was like, oh my gosh, what's this guy doing?
All right, a little update. We haven't caught anything yet. Big Steve guide trip. Not really getting my money's worth right now. He said he's gonna take us to his honey hole. He said he has one honey hole that we haven't hit yet. What do you think? So if his honey hole doesn't work, then I might hop in and we might go try to find some deeper fish, because I think these fish moved off. This last week got really cold and I think these fish are all in a weird, you know, they're moving. It's a lot different than last week. When did you go? It's been about a week, right? Yeah, these fish have changed a lot, but we're gonna go to this spot, see what's going on, and if they're not there, we're gonna try something completely different and try to find some big fish.
Get him. Biggin. Uh-oh. Big Steve got him on at the juice hole. Not a bad one.
He's a little guy.
Little spot. He loaded up like a big one. That's a large mouth, homie. That is crazy. If you guys didn't know, I mean, you don't catch largemouth on linear. That's a pretty little largemouth. You weren't recording.
It's not.
Come on, YouTuber. Dang it.
It was off?
Dang it. Yeah.
What's it doing? I got a blue
thing. You're taking photos,
right?
Aren't you? Yep. Bass. It's a little largemouth.
That's some big bass energy right there.
Dude, when you loaded up on him, he seemed big. He didn't seem like that small. That's crazy. It's a little large.
Gonna catch his mama.
A little largey.
Where's your mama at, boy?
Guys, as I always say, it's just good to get a fish in the boat. You know, it doesn't matter the size for the first ones.
There he is.
You got another one?
He just whacked the heck out of me.
Really?
Oh, he just hit me again, son.
He's on there. Get him. Biggin? Dude, they're down there. That's another largemouth, isn't it? Yo, that's insane, actually. That's another largemouth. Oh, my God. Dude, that's crazy. Look at that. That is crazy, man.
Yeah.
Look at that. Big Steve got him another one, like, next cast right there. Look what he's got. He don't have a underspin. He doesn't have a fish head. He's got literally just a swim bait head. That's it. You got two of them. That's a little fat, chunky dude. Nice. Oh, gosh. Dude.
Yeah, it's lobber dog, dude.
Yeah, his teeth marks are on it, too. I just letting it sit. I didn't even move it. I just threw it in there, kind of let it sink to the bottom. I'm throwing a fluke. I don't know if I ever talked about this. It's the only other bait I tied on, you know. I have that underspin and then a little fluke. Oh, there he is. There he is. I got him.
Oh, you got the
yep. Oh, he ain't big. Another largemouth. Look how he choked it, dude. It's crazy.
That's good stuff.
Choke that fluke. So far today, and they've all been largemouth. Really small, you know, that's not a big deal at all. That we just got on some fish right here. We caught, what, 3 and 5 minutes? Mm-hmm. And they've all been largemouth, and I've probably caught 20, maybe 15 largemouth in my lifetime fishing Lake Lanier. So to catch three right now is just kind of bizarre. They're not big, but still pretty little fish, and got him on a fluke. My dad's got those last two on a swim bait, so get him back in the water. We still got to hunt for those big ones. The big bass that we're going to catch today, probably not going to be largemouth. Probably going to be some big spots, so... Let's keep on covering some water. I think right here we're going to continue to fish. What is going on? And because there's a lot of fish in this area. But Big Steve's taking the boat over the fish right now. So I guess we'll see what happens. What are you doing, man?
I'm stuck.
He's gonna run over the fish.
He keeps nipping at it. He was nipping at it right there. Where are you at?
Next to the jet ski dock. Yeah, let's get this thing synced. Dude, he missed it.
I don't know, but I watched that.
How big was that fish, dude?
I watched his ass. Look, you got it.
You got it.
Oh, it's a biggin'. Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's a big spot. I haven't caught one of these in a minute. These things fight so good. It's a big spot. About 3 pounds. I thought he was 4. That's a good one. He ain't 3 pounds. What do you say, high two? High 2 pounder, maybe?
I just say he's
Look at that right there. Dude, I was like, dude, he had to missed it. You know what I mean?
He hit it, he missed it, he came back, hit it again, missed it, then he came back, swirled on it again.
Gosh.
The third time he got waylaid.
I'll tell you, his lips are very sharp too. He's been eating bait fish. Look at that fluke hanging out of his mouth right there. Pretty little spot. He's only about 2.5 pounds. I thought he was like a 4 pounder. Then I thought he was like a 3 pounder, and now he's like a 2.5. They shrink when they come to the boat. But hey, I ain't complaining. If I had a scale, I'd actually put him on the scale, but I bet you he's like about a 2.5. These are hefty, hefty spots. This is one thing I love about spots, guys. The beautiful markings on these fish. Like, you just look at their lateral line right there. It's got these beautiful black markings. And there's overall really pretty bass. Like this largemouth that we caught a second ago, they're not as pretty as these spots. And that's not a big spot by any means. I mean, on some lakes it is, but you know, I know we can catch a bigger one today. But that's a great start. You know, we caught 4 fish on this corner. On Big Steve's juice hole, I guess the guide trip paid off and my money was well spent, but it's a pretty fish right there. Let's get a release back here. Should I?
What?
Should I live well it? You know what? Let's do it. Let's do it. We're in largemouth territory. We could get like a crazy largey, and I would want to take a picture of the spot next to him. Big dinosaur. Well, there we go, guys. That is our 4th fish of the day. The day has changed very quickly, which we haven't been out here long, but you know, we did pull up and catch 4 fish right there. I guess we're going to work our way back right here, throw around, and we'll probably work our way back towards that mouth because there's just so many fish right there. So that fish just came up. We actually saw him roll on it, and he just never had it. I popped it a couple more times. The fish came up, rolled on it again, and he had it that time. And it was a good little spot. Not a giant, but, you know, it was a good little spotted bass right there. Hope we can find us a good 3.5 to 5 pounder today, which is very possible. It's got to cover water. We only got a couple hours of the fish, so. I was talking about a spot, but it could get a massive largemouth, so yeah. Wouldn't that be crazy? I don't know, just missed out on fish bites and I guess. I know exactly where to go. We're gonna catch one real quick. We're about to catch one.
There he is. He hit me twice.
Get him. That's a biggin. He's a biggin, boy. Yeah. That's a good one.
Oh yeah.
What'd I say? I know we're gonna catch one here. You got you a good spot.
You called it.
That's a good one. That's bigger than, might be bigger than the one I caught.
You gonna grab him?
Yeah, I can grab him. Or you want a boat flip him?
I don't want a boat flip him once you reach down and get him.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's a nice one. He ate it good, too. Look at that. Big Steve just got him about a 2 pounder. He ain't as big as that last, but he's a good one. They're so thick and chunky. Look at them, beautiful. Markings on them spots. Just pulled up to this spot. It's the first spot that I looked at on the graph. I just sat down and drove over here, and it's a good fish. There should be some more here. It's a pretty spot. What you want to say? You want to show it to your camera?
I got that big bass energy, baby.
That's a good
one. You know
what's
up?
He ain't a mega, but he's a good one. What's up?
Yeah, I'm
yeah, we might as well. There's gonna be one on.
No,
that's a good one, ain't it?
Another one.
Don't matter. Just get. You can about push me in the water. He's in the same spot, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Another spot.
Another good size one, 2.5 maybe.
Right there, brother.
Oh, he's beautiful. Don't spit it.
That's a good one. A little fat one.
Oh, yeah.
That's crazy. Look at that. That one's got pretty colors on him, dude.
Daddy Van Dam's getting her done.
Look at this. He just, was that your next cast?
Two casts after.
They're on the spot. We're going to catch some here. I'm excited. That's a good one. I might need to put me a little swim bait back on. That fish head that I got on so big profile, but it's a pretty spot. Just fat.
Got one?
You're right, I got one. It's tiny. But... You good?
Now that.
That's a giant.
Is what I'm calling big bass energy right there, homie.
That's a largemouth, too.
That's serious, some big bass energy right there.
It's a freaking toad. No. Look at that one. You hope, but that's still on the board. You're complaining earlier, like, we're not counting size.
Oh,
we're not counting size.
Yeah, but we're talking about fish, not minnows.
Okay, we're going to go to a new spot. We don't have much daylight left. And pretty much what I'm looking at, we're in... I'm not even going to say the name of this creek, actually. I've never fished up here before. Him and Perry come up here all the time. This is like largemouth territory. If you guys, you know, fish Lake Lanier, you probably know what creek I'm talking about. This is the first time I fished up here, and it does fish a lot different. You know, you fish, if we were on the south end of the lake right now, we'd be fishing a lot different stuff. There's actually a lot of bait up there. What I'm looking for is pretty much these banks that have that steeper drop-off. So, you know, when we came back in here, that first spot that we hit, it had a steep drop-off. You could tell it was a big bluff bank with rock and clay. And there's fish on it. We pulled up and got bit instantly. Even this one was the same way. We pulled up, got bit instantly. So when you find a pattern like that, when you find where those fish are sitting on, you just duplicate it. So, you know, I found that first spot. I looked at the second spot that looked most similar to it. When I came over to it, it looked totally different. But there's still fish on it, the way it sets up on the graph. So I'm going to hit one or two more spots. There's a couple good rocky spots over here that I think we can catch some fish on. There he is. I got him. There we go. You know,
one down?
Nope. That ties me up right here.
No.
Yes, it does.
No.
What am I doing? It's another largemouth. Dude, we caught more largemouth than spots today. How many is that? That's 5 largemouth out of 8 fish. That's crazy. Spots have been the bigger ones, but it's a little fat guy. Look at that. A little fat largy. That's 4-4.
All right, sucker. All
right, guys, we're going to release these good couple of spotted bass we caught earlier. We had a couple other decent ones as well, but we didn't put them in the well. Those are some pretty fish. Took a little picture for the Instagram because I just never take any pictures anymore. So I was like, you know what? Today's a good day. Get a good picture of some spotted bass. Get them back in the water. That's a good little fat one. That was the one I caught on a fluke. That was a good fish.